young Tony there?
That's her 40th. I was 11 years old. That's my sister at her wedding.
I like this too.
I had a hair mark.
I had to cut it myself. My parents didn't have a lot of money.
You got the big bowl out and went to town, Bobby.
Zip, zip, zip. And our scissors weren't very good either.
Not the sharpest.
You hadn't gotten your contacts yet, right?
By this? Yeah, right? I was in need of them, but
that's
no,
right.
I did not
have
like
them. He's like 20-100.
I'm like...
That's right.
Oh, wait a minute.
Squinting.
Oh, jeez. I mean,
here he comes. So you're not that bad, are you? Just talking about him.
Talking about him.
Markel Fultz, everybody.
Markel, how are you?
How you guys doing?
Good.
It was great. I mean, I came in here, got some shots up, which I love to do. Every time I get a chance to step in the gym and put some work in, I love it. So,
what do you think makes you like the best player available on this
team? First of all, I think how I carry myself as a player and as a young man, just being humble, and I think I'm just a hard worker, and I'm gonna do whatever it takes to help any team I go to win. So,
is this a tough day? You drive all the way up here and then. Boom, just run out onto the court and do whatever. Was that tough getting out of a car and just trying to have to perform for these guys?
Not really. I mean, it's almost like AAU, driving out of town to wherever you're going and going to play some AAU games. So, like I said, it's something I love to do, and any chance I get an opportunity to do it, I'm gonna be excited. So.
How long did it take you to get here from Maryland?
Not that long. Probably I was sleeping pretty much the whole way, but I mean, I come to Philly a lot, so probably like 3 hours or something like that, so not too far.
What's the latest with the knee? And if you can, maybe explain to us what was wrong with it, because we never really got a good explanation. How's it feel now?
Yeah, my knee is great. As you can see, I'm jumping pretty high and everything like that. And it was just a situation where I had some stuff going on with my knee. I really don't want to address it, but I mean, it was what was best for me as a player, so that's what I did.
And so fully recovered now. You're good.
Yep.
Okay.
What do you make of all these swirling, swapping picks with Boston, Sixers, and you're in the middle of all this?
I really don't pay a lot of attention to it. I mean, I'm blessed enough. I pray every night before I go to sleep, and I let God take care of it, really. I wake up every morning and get ready to go to the gym. I don't really pay attention to everything that's going on, but I'm truly blessed to be in this position, really, and wherever happens, I'm looking forward to taking my talents to wherever I go. So.
As someone who wasn't heavily recruited out of high school, what do you make of all this fanfare surrounding you being the number one pick in the draft? Did you ever think you would really be at this point in your career?
It was a dream I had since I was a young kid, but like I said, it just shows how much hard work I put in and how dedicated I am to do what I do. I set goals for myself and I go out there and achieve them. So.
And what was the thought of rocking the Sixers cap coming into the building?
Pretty cool. I mean, like I said, I come to Philly a lot and just showing the love for the city. I mean, I'm out here, want to show love, so that's all it was.
So no one gave you that hat? Like the Sixers didn't give it to you? You already had it?
Yeah, I had a Philly hat.
Oh, okay. Yeah. All right. And what would it be like for you to play here? I mean, like you said, it's a couple hours away. Mm-hmm. You come to Philly a lot. What would it be like to be a Sixer?
I think it would be pretty cool just being with the young team. I think the upside of it would be crazy. And like I said, I'm close to home, so a lot of my fans can come out and just show love. And this city has great fans, so I think it would be true.
How many team hats do you have?
I don't know. I have a lot of hats at home, so I mean, it was just one I picked out. So.
Joel posted a photo earlier on Instagram.
Yeah.
Yeah. With your name playing. Yeah. I mean, what did it mean to you to see that, and what do you think about, you know,
players here wanted you?
Yeah, first of all, I mean, Embiid, I mean, me and him been talking before when I was in college, just been in a relationship. I mean, he's a cool guy. Just give me tips and pointers, and he's pretty funny. So when I seen that, I mean, it was just pretty cool and pretty funny. So I'm pretty happy that the players here wanted me to come in. So
Markel, when you were here in April, the Sixers got blown out by the Brooklyn Nets. Was there anything you saw in that game that you were like, I can be like a good addition for this team?
I mean, not really. I mean, I saw the team still fighting hard, and the most important thing was the fans in the building were still there no matter what. I think that was big, and of course, I mean, being out there, I could see myself, imagine myself on the court helping the team out for sure. That's what I do every game I watch. I just think about if I was on that team, what could happen. So
how would you play with a 6'10 point guard like Ben Simmons?
Just like I play with great players all the time, so whatever he needs me to do, if I'm running the floor trying to score the ball, or if I'm setting the screen for him or getting it and giving it back, it doesn't matter. I mean, I'm going to be a great teammate. If that's me on the bench clapping for him, I mean, it doesn't matter to me. So
how do you think your skill set would fit with their system?
I think it'd be great. I mean, get up and down, and big. They're big on defense, so I think the tools I have to be a defensive player, I think that'll help them get out in transition. I'm a pretty good shot blocker for a point guard, so I think helping them with that, I mean, everything would pretty much help that.
When did this all arrangement to come tonight? When did that take place?
It was about a 2-day process. I mean, yesterday and night before. I mean, my mom and my trainer pretty much handed it. I just wake up and go where they tell me to go. So, I mean, waking up and they said, we got to go to Philly. I was just like, okay, I'm ready for it. So, I think it was like yesterday and the day before that, I think they were deciding where we was going to go next, like after the Laker workout. And that's just where we decided to go. So,
how long will you spend in Philadelphia, and what is the rest of your trip going to consist of?
I'm definitely going to go get some cheesesteak from somewhere. You know, I got to get a cheesesteak. I'm big on that.
Do you know what spot?
I've been to Larry's a couple times. I think it's some other good spots around here, and that's pretty much better than that. But I'm not sure yet. I'm gonna leave it up to my trainer, my mom, to pick out a good spot. But I don't know how long I'm gonna be here. I live not too far away, so it's just a quick ride home. So
I know you say you try not to pay attention to everything that's happened the last few days. But what has the last few days been like as far as the seesaw, Boston here, and then the draft next week?
It's been crazy, man. Just knowing that the draft is a couple days away, it's been unbelievable. I mean, it's been a blessing, like I said, a dream I always had, and I'm just anxious to get to that day and just get it over with so I can know where I'm going and put full invest into whatever team I'm going to.
So are you going to meet with, like, have a meeting with Brett Brown, you know, have dinner? There was a report that you were going to go to dinner with them as well.
I'm not sure. Like I said, I just got off the court, and I'm not sure where I'm doing that. So if that happens, I guess so. So I'm open for anything. So.
Did you have to take a physical with them, or did they get the results of your physical?
They just pretty much got, I mean, I did some stuff in there with the doctors, but I'm pretty sure they getting everything situated with that. So
thanks, Markel.
Yep.
Thanks, appreciate it. Markel, thanks. Good luck.
Appreciate it. Good luck.